So, what is the best way to increase your cash flow? So that way you can take advantage of strategies like velocity banking and knock down your debts quicker. You know, in today's video, I'm going to give you four ways to increase your cash flow. A couple of them will be pretty obvious, but I think one of them will really surprise you. And then I'll let you know the number one, my favorite way to increase your cash flow in today's training. Hey guys, it's Mike Adams, and on this channel, we empower individuals to achieve freedom through improved financial literacy, business ownership. And for those of you, it's your first time here on this channel, make sure to click subscribe, click the bell, so that way you get notified on any and all of our future content. So in today's video, we're gonna be talking about four ways that you can increase your cash flow. So that way you can take advantage of some of the other strategies we're talking about on this channel, and then again, move forward to wealth creation, okay? And moving towards financial independence. So the first way, okay, to increase your cash flow, again, it's pretty straightforward. It's to decrease your expenses, okay? And oftentimes, that's the one that people don't necessarily want to do. They don't necessarily want to cut the budget. And I'll tell you this, right? And especially as an entrepreneur myself, we don't always like to take steps backwards. What I mean by reducing expenses is obviously we're not looking to live necessarily a smaller life, but a lot of times, a lot of expenses that we pay every single month, think about some of the different memberships. Think about, gosh, as an entrepreneur, how many free trials for different software programs and music subscriptions, you know, movie subscriptions, things like that, that you get all these different monthly recurring charges that are just kind of flowing out of your bank account or hitting your credit card every single month. And a lot of times we forget about these little small, what seem like insignificant charges. But a lot of times you can recoup anywhere from 50 to 100 plus, for some folks, even more per month in just frivolous expenses that, you know, are just, you're just attached to things that you don't even really use. So cut the frivolous expenses out of your life. Obviously, you still want to enjoy life. You still want to, you know, bring your paycheck home and you still want to, you know, enjoy life. But as far as all the frivolous expenses and things that you just simply don't need, get rid of them, reduce those expenses, get them out of your life. That right there will increase your monthly cash flow. So the second thing that you can do to increase your cash flow is to pay off more of your debts, okay? Now, and again, very straightforward, but if you're able, think about this, if you're able to eliminate your car loan, right, that payment that you're sending off every single month, you know, now that payment, you don't have to send that off anymore. So that instantly increases your cash flow by that payment amount. So if you can start eliminating your debts, and again, using some of the different strategies that we talk about on this channel, combine that with reducing some of the frivolous expenses out of your life, you can knock down those debts. That will increase your cash flow. So the third thing that you can do to increase your cash flow is you can actually refinance some of your debts. And now some of you guys might give me the evil eye for this one, say, Mike, you know, you've talked to us about refinancing before. You told us that refinancing was evil. And the truth is, yes, you know, maybe refinancing is and can be evil. Really, refinancing, simply put, is a tool. And when we talk about it in other strategies, a lot of folks simply refinance because they think that they're somehow saving money. And what we realize is that when you refinance, let's say you're into a mortgage, you know, 10 years, and all of a sudden you refinance, yes, you are resetting that clock. Okay, so we need to understand that about refinancing. But this video here is about increasing your cash flow. So I want you to think about this, okay? Let's say you have multiple credit card payments going on where you got, let's say, $2,500 per month going out to various credit cards. Plus you got a car loan, plus you got, you know, maybe a couple other, you know, business loans or medical payments for medical bills that you have. Perhaps it's a student loan, whatever the case may be. And you have, you know, $5,000 worth of payments going out every single month. If you're in a good income and in a good credit scenario where you can actually qualify for a full refinance, you might be able to consolidate, you know, $5,000 worth of outgoing monthly expenses into one payment at about $3,500, okay, per month, which immediately would increase your cash flow by $1,500, okay? Now, here's another thing to think about if you're considering a refinance, okay? Because again, we know that that resets the clock on the amortization. when you refinance, the point of it is to go into a refinance with an actual plan to start being a little bit different with your money, okay? Because again, the reason that you're refinancing in this situation, we're talking about consolidating a bunch of different debts down into one debt, you know, obviously we accumulated all that debt, so we need to do things differently after this refinance. And obviously here on this channel, we talk about various strategies where you can attack these loans, and really knock down that debt service much, much quicker and save a lot of money on interest. If somebody was to do a refinance, okay, and let's say, so now you've increased your cash flow by, you know, let's call it $1,500, but now you have a new strategy. Now you have that fresh, you know, loan there with a fresh amortization. What can we do to attack this loan in a better way to knock it down much, much quicker and save a ton of money in interest? Okay, you could start using velocity banking strategy right away on a fresh new loan and save a lot of money. A lot of times when somebody's looking to refinance, it's like, okay, let's think about this. We're gonna do this. Yes, we wanna do it to increase our cash flow, but what is our plan of attack once we have this fresh new, fully amortized loan? How, you know, what tool can we put in place to immediately take a chunk off that loan and start living a new strategy here that's going to allow us to pay down the debt quickly and not accumulate all the debts that we accumulated in the first place, which obviously prompted the refinance. So bottom line there, guys, is obviously we understand that refinancing is a tough thing to do. And yes, it does reset the clock on the amortization. But again, in some scenarios, it is beneficial to increase the cash flow. You always got to think about what your particular goals are. You know, if you're looking to eliminate debt quickly and get rid of debt, you know, obviously refinancing is not necessarily the best way to do it, especially if you're looking to save on interest. However, if your immediate goal is to increase your cash flow, refinancing can be a great tool to go ahead and do that, make your life a lot simpler, and as well, increase your cash flow immediately. And the fourth way for you to increase your cash flow is to simply put, increase your earnings. Start making more money, okay? And there's a lot of different ways that you could do that. Obviously, you could pick up more hours at your job. You could pick up a second job, right, on the employee side of it. For me personally, what I recommend is to start your own business, okay? And for some folks, that might sound really big, like, Mike, I don't wanna start a big corporation. You know, the bottom line is this, you know, I know many, many folks that are hardcore W-2 employees, have been in corporate America for, you know, 30, 40 years. But they do as well have a side business. And it's something that they do very, very part-time. It's on their schedule, okay? And again, it's something that you own and control. And it also opens up the door to a multitude of tax benefits. Okay, and I'll create a whole that calls for a whole nother video about the business, about the benefits of being a business owner, and so we'll look to create that in the very near future. But there are so many benefits to you, especially on the tax side of it. You know, as an employee, we have about 15 tax deductions that we can take. As a business owner, as an entrepreneur, it opens up the door to over 400 different deductions that you have the ability to take, obviously if you qualify for them, inside of your business. But it allows you to reduce your taxable income and keep more of the money that you earn. If you found value in this training, make sure to give it a like, give it a comment below. And let me know, guys, you know, I talked about my four ways to increase your cash flow. There's all kinds of different ways out there. I even shared with you guys my favorite way, which is to increase your income through starting a small business. And guys, when it comes to starting a small business, it can be something as simple as flipping one house a year, picking up one rental property a year, which again, that stuff is gonna move you towards financial freedom. But a business can be something as simple as selling Beanie Babies on eBay. And I know that dates me a little bit, Beanie Babies. The millennials are probably thinking, what the heck is a Beanie Baby? But that used to be a business, right? Just selling these things online. So there's all kinds of different ways that you could start something very, very, very small, okay? Structure it as a business. And from there, that income is gonna increase your cash flow. And again, open the doors to a multitude of tax benefits. So again, guys, you know, make sure to give this video a like, give it a comment. And if I didn't cover your favorite way to increase your cash flow in this video, make sure to comment below and let me know your favorite way to increase your cash flow. We'll see you guys in the next training.